The director of the most important think tank in the United Kingdom has written a decisive report to X-ray the future of the country after Brexit, and with some interesting examples. We have won the Cold War, but we have lost Eurovision. This is how Terry Wogan, the famous BBC presenter, expressed his frustration in 2007, accusing the music contest of having a blatant bias against the United Kingdom and blaming the poor results on the votes of the countries of Eastern Europe. The Irishman thus crystallized a common sentiment among the British people. We lose at Eurovision because our neighbors don't love us. Over the years, that idea mutated and Brexit was blamed for the few votes it got, but even the tabloids soon recognized that it had nothing to do with it. Brexit is not why we are the last, was the headline of an opinion column in 2019. But the problem of running out of allies, although it should not worry the British in the next edition of the contest in 2021, it should do so in geostrategic terms. After leaving the EU, the UK runs the risk of being lonelier than ever. That is the thesis of David Niblett, director of the prestigious British think tank Chatham House, who cites the Eurovision effect as a possible consequence after Brexit. Without the loyalty of its closest European colleagues, but without other countries forced to prioritize relations with the United Kingdom over their neighbors or even over great powers, London could find itself pushed aside to the margin of international negotiations, Niblett writes in a recent report entitled Global Britain, Global Broker. In this paper of more than 70 pages, Niblett proposes a new path for British foreign policy after Brexit. Instead of dreaming of being a new global power again and dealing face to face with China, the United States or the European Union, something that would be nothing more than giving wings to an impossible nostalgia, has to recover the old British pragmatism. Cooperate internationally and become the plumber who is capable of solving global challenges, or the firefighter who douses a world on fire while still acknowledging that the glorious days of the UK are a thing of the past. The first thing we have to recognize is that there is no return to the past. The UK will not be such a powerful country to be able to be autonomous, especially at a time of high geopolitical competition, explains Niblett. British citizens and leaders must accept that their country is a different power than the one that entered the EU in the past, hoping that its membership could be influential to retain some of its past glory. And it ends, the United Kingdom will fail if it tries to reincarnate itself into a miniature superpower. It should focus on being able to solve some international problems. What are these global challenges or problems? Niblett puts them at six. The UK has the opportunity to defend liberal democracy, promote international peace and security, fight climate change, achieve greater resilience on health issues, advocate for global fiscal transparency, support equitable economic growth, and protect cyberspace. Of course, Niblett is not naive. The text is still impregnated with slight pessimistic touches. He knows that selling the idea of global UK was always difficult when in other capitals, both outside and within the EU, the logic of Brexit was never understood. The government's use of the term global UK implies that leaving the EU frees the UK to engage in more international agreements than before. However, Brexit was an act of decoupling from its biggest partners. But the director of the British think tank is also optimistic. Your country continues to have a very great soft power that translates into the best universities, highly influential media, seats in all the major international organizations, including the Security Council, and a powerful economy. Having all this, however, does not mean that British leaders can sit idly by, because the weak response to the government of Boris Johnson against the pandemic damages the credibility of the country, according to Niblett, to solve problems abroad. On the other hand, it remains in doubt whether Brexit will not end up fragmenting the country, with Scottish pro-independence leaders promoting another referendum, and with the Northern Irish wondering if the time has come for reunification with the rest of Ireland. Another positive albeit more indirect aspect is that the UK will no longer be able to blame the EU for its problems. Although it's very funny that many Brexiteers in my comments now blame the EU for making everything complicated for the British. And at the same time say we better have gone WTO. What is making everything complicated at the moment? And for the time being until whatever happens, is those parts that are not regulated in the current agreement. Those parts that are reserved for the members. What is making these issues is those parts of trade and or the relationship that is running on basis of WTO. So that what you want to blame the EU for at the moment is WTO rules. And that you wanted for everything? Think again. And Niblet says, by being more alone in the world, the British will have a great incentive to fix their own problems and they will have no choice but to do so. And once again, you can write in the comments whatever you want. You will have to deal with these problems on your own. It's not our responsibility anymore. For Niblet, belonging to the EU has disconnected British leaders from traditional British pragmatism. For decades, they have been immersed in endless debates about the EU. However, the fact that Brexit has ended up being solved does not mean that the United Kingdom has already solved its problems with the EU. Geographic proximity and deep economic interconnection will force the economic government and its European partners to a constant commitment, writes Niblet. The net result, however, is that the UK will end up wasting more time managing its relationship with the European institutions than when it was a member of the EU. In the report's conclusion, Niblet is blunt. The world we live in needs less talk and more action. The United Kingdom has to win the role of global actor that fixes the problem of the world, being able to put aside the nostalgia for the empire and understand that it is no longer a superpower. Because if it does not take the risk, as he famously said about Peter Cook, of ending up sinking into the sea while laughing. And if you want to stay informed, please subscribe to my channel and to my other channels. I'll see you in my next video. Auf Wiedersehen.